When it comes to the question of whether you dive in head first or whether you take baby steps, I think the answer is probably that you do both. Meaning you find a place where you know you can make a difference. So maybe that's going to be through the automation of your infrastructure. Maybe that's going to be improving test coverage. Maybe it's going to be implementing some continuous integration or even a step toward continuous delivery. And you should really dive in with the full intention to realize that value. At the same time, though, you want sort of agile principles to be able to work for you in this context. So I don't know how a mountain goat approaches the mountain, right? But I think it's with the intention of getting where it wants to go. But how does it do it? It takes a tentative step at each time. It tests a little bit, right? How did that work for me? And then moves forward. And I think that's the way that you should do it. So you should bring your whole self, your whole intention to the effort. Let me just give an example of what going all in could mean in a negative way or in a different context. Like you go out and you buy all the things, you buy all the software, you hire a giant team. Like, I don't think you have to start in that way. I think what you have to be clear about is where you want to get to and what thing you're going to do first to make an impact. And I think that's the thing you go all in on. Often the places where a DevOps engineer is going to be asked to start working are in the places where the organization is feeling the most pain or is suffering the most. So I guess there's nobility there in the same way that there is for an early responder. Like, I don't want to make this overly dramatic. There's a book that I really love. It's called Your Code is a Crime Scene. Like, and if that's real and there's some evidence to support that idea, the DevOps engineer shows up in that space and is going to work to make things better. So all in on an area in which you can make an effort, that's really going to pay off. All in some global sense, like I have to decide early on what tooling I pay for, I have to decide early on what methodologies I use, I think that might be a mistake. As a matter of fact, you'd be creating structure ahead of any kind of learning, and that might be damaging. So I like the mountain goat metaphor, you know?